2020. I am sitting with Key from Dover Amplification.
Hi, how you doing?
I'm very good, mate. Very good. How are you?
Yeah. I'm good.
Getting there.
I'm good now.
Getting there, yeah.
I'm good now, yeah.
So this is something I'm sure you've all read about in social media. We won't go too far into it. Suffice to say, Dover Amps have overcome some serious adversity this year.
Yeah, man.
In style, man. We're looking forward to seeing the amps.
Well, that's it. We were very lucky. Obviously, everything got stolen, but we were... I don't know if it was foresight, but we made two prototypes of everything. Yeah. Which makes perfect sense.
It does.
So we've flown everything over. Half of it came last night. Some of it came this morning.
Yeah.
And we're still waiting for the rest that's stuck at LAX. But either way, you know, we're an English amp company. Stiff upper lip. Got to persevere.
Well, let's talk about the amps. So, let's start at the top. So what do we have?
Okay, so what we've done here is the ethos behind those amps is really to create hugely versatile tones.
Uh-huh.
Now that comes all the way from beautiful clean tones, very sort of like, if you want to, I mean, for me, the nicest clean amp was always sort of a Vox kind of creamy, chimey tone.
Yeah.
You get a lot of other amps like the Hubbard Boss, they can do that. But what we did with Dover was we took the best of the clean, the best of the crunch, and the best of the high gain, put it all in one amp. The 20 watt sort of typifies that quite well of what kind of amp Dover's about.
Yeah.
So on this one, I mean, it's all made in England. It's we're based in Sheffield, we use Sheffield Steel. For this, basically there's kind of three channels in one amp. So you've got the clean here, you've got the push-pull crunch, and then you've got the channel switch over to the gain. It's 20 watts, it's switchable down to 7 watts. And what we did with this, also, with the design team, we're very much into aesthetics as well. So, with the cage, we got the stuff like putting the branding on the back, the coat of arms and things. It's just, for us, it's a nice bit of branding, but really it's all about how the amp sounds. This is absolute killer. We've had one guy review it already that's out there, but he loved it. And this really is it's a high output 20 watt.
So you can take that, you can gig with it.
Absolutely. It's got, obviously, we've got the external biasing of it. It's foot switchable. And really, it goes everything from very nice, clean sort of jazz tones, if you like, all the way up to some serious sort of high-gain metal. Yeah.
So this is like an amp for everyone. This is, whatever you're into, or if you need to cover a lot of ground, this is...
Absolutely, and we know that there's a lot of gigging artists out there who love the size of the 50 watters, but we also know that the market very much tends towards the smaller sort of, sometimes lunchbox. So you've got the lunchbox style there, you've got a small 20 watt there as well, which has different voicings and is a bit different.
So it looks a lot simpler across the front panel.
It looks similar. Instead of lunchbox, you've got the wooden exterior.
Yeah.
You've also, this is basically designed just to have that great clean tone.
Yeah.
What it also has is it has a push-pull crunch.
Oh.
So that's got a pure tube overdriven sort of overdrive that comes from two EL84s.
Uh-huh.
So it's got the send and return. All the amps come with sort of level-ready send and returns. Obviously, we've got the multiple switching here for the voltages.
Right.
So it does everywhere from Japan at 100 all the way over to 240 in England.
Magic.
Or the UK, sorry.
That's really important, especially with these kind of, like you say, these kind of gig-ready amps that you could conceivably, I mean, this one especially, you could fly with that. That could go in an overhead locker,
absolutely.
It's the right size, yeah. So.
Absolutely. And it's kept the weight down on it. I mean, that's absolutely nothing.
Oh, man, that doesn't weigh anything,
So with this one, we've got the send and return with all of them, but this one, it's a great pedal platform.
That's what I was going to say. So this is for the pedal user.
Yeah, and obviously I've been in the industry quite a few years. Where I've come from, it's very sort of, they're known for being clean amps, pedal platforms. So this kind of thing is kind of my bag.
Yeah, no,
this is hand-wired as well. And so, we say Dover amps are handcrafted because that's how we see it. We try to craft something and give value to the end user,
I mean, the crunch thing is kind of, it's a lot more important for a pedal amp than people kind of give it credit for. Because you're going to have pedals that are going to take a really high headroom clean, you're going to have pedals that are going to prefer to go into something a little broken up. So just having the option to switch between the two is
great. And the idea, you get that really old school sort of valve drive, which is very sort of like the Who and bands like that used to get that kind of crunch from. Probably they were using sort of slightly different amps then. Some of them, you know, people were using US branded amps then, but in sonorous with that sort of English tone.
That's what we're trying to get to.
We love that sort of UK vibe and things. And we're flying the flag with SMP guitars here. We're proud to be British.
Absolutely, man. We're a British magazine, you know.
EL34, EL84. We got the best tone.
Well, we make the best amps. That's the thing, you know. British amps.
Okay, so let's talk about the big boy. This is the 50 watts.
This is the DA50.
Yeah.
And basically, this is our flagship amplifier.
Yeah.
So, and the reason for that is, and it doesn't take away from any of these, this just has more features.
Cool.
It is what I would certainly use in my first proper band.
Yeah.
And what you get is, unlike the other 220s, which is the LE4s, you get that big, thick, rich EL34 sound. That is synonymous with so many UK bands, legendary bands throughout the years, and also the common ones.
Yeah.
So what we have here basically is, it's a two-channel amp with multiple features. It's a shared EQ. So you've got the bass, middle, treble, but you also have the presence and the depth. Now the depth and the presence work with each other, and that helps create more sonic variety.
And you can mash that to your cab and to the room and
absolutely. Yeah. And so as these work sonically, it gives you more options. It's often with these sort of amps, because they're high-end amps, it's the nuances that make the amp.
Yeah,
where
that
the
makes
people
the
just want to dial that a little bit extra in.
Yeah, yeah.
So what you have on here is, it's multifunctional. By that we mean you have four gain stages, but you have master one, master two, so it's a two-channel amp.
Fantastic.
But it also has a boost, which is a shared boost that basically you can switch on and off.
That's a front-end boost, not like a second master. That's like a gain boost in the front end.
It's a front end boost. It's a valve-driven boost that comes through. So that's the extra gain stage.
Brilliant.
So you've got three gain stages.
And that's for both channels.
Yes, it is. It's a shared boost. So you can dial in your clean tone here, for instance. Then you can switch over to obviously a bit more of a rhythm gain, a rhythm overdrive, and then you've got the boost for your solos. Yeah. It does everything from, like I said, jazz all the way up to that real sort of heavy detuned. It's tight as anything. So you've got those detuned guitars, you've got the baritone guitars. I mean, when we tested this, we tested it on Drop Me,
which
is like what the Architects use and bands like that. But also works well with baritone. So it really allows you to sort of keep that low end tightness, which often with other amps sort of filters out
and
becomes a bit flabby. This, not a chance.
Not that, man.
So
really excited to hear it.
Yeah, so this is kind of our flagship. This is one we're not most proud of. We're proud of all of them, this for me, this is what I have at home, and this is what I use.
Now it's interesting because this kind of amp it kind of exists at both ends of the market, because you kind of have, like I say, your big touring pros are going to take something like this, but you also find people who aren't touring artists who are playing locally. Maybe they're not micing up, maybe you're playing in a bar or whatever.
Yeah.
Something like this is appropriate for that kind of gig, because you don't have to ship it around the world.
No.
You know, you got plenty of power to throw to the back of a room. Maybe you don't have a 57 in front of it. But then in the middle you have this sort of thing for the touring artist, for people who are kind of,
It works. I mean, take the DA50 for instance.
Yeah.
It's got a level ready send and return.
Yeah.
That works for all your pedals. Again, it's got a great pure pedal platform.
Yeah.
It's also got the switching, which works really well. It basically does it all. It's also, you've attenuated down to 20 watts.
Yeah.
So you still get that thunk and that punch when you're playing at home or you're rehearsing and you don't want to blow your ears.
Yeah.
So, I mean, overall, it's a similar ethos for every amp, because we're a new brand and we want to create our tone.
Yeah.
Marshall's synonymous with the Marshall tone.
Yeah.
I want to be synonymous with the Dover tone.
Brilliant. Well,
and that's the idea.
Man, very excited to get your hands on them. Hopefully we'll be able to get some in for review so we can show you guys what it sounds like. Very, very exciting prospect. Keith, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
All the best.
We will see you guys somewhere down the road. NAMM 2020 coverage continues. Yeah.